So a few weeks ago, I built this extension that allows me to search all of the videos we've uploaded to YouTube. What I want to do now is basically create another command to this extension so I can see how many subscribers we have. And I think I want to make this as a menu bar command so I can always see it, basically. So yeah, let's start coding. First thing I'm going to do is open up the extension project. And this is a private extension. It's only available for the members of the Raycast organization. And as you can see, we've got quite a few private extensions here. That's for us. Over here, we have this extension, Search Raycast YouTube. First thing I'm going to do is add a new command. And this is going to be a menu bar command. We'll give it a name. Let's say stats, right? Or actually, let's call it subscribers count. That makes more sense, no? And the mode is going to be menu bar. Next thing, we open up the source folder and we create a new file, which is called subscriberscount.tsx. We're going to basically start building the extension, shall we? So we export a function and this can be our command. And then we're going to return. This is the thing that we know for sure we're going to do, which is going to be a menu bar extra. Let's give it just a title here and say 5,000, because that's kind of like a goal of ours. And then I'm going to open up terminal and just run this. So we go into this package extension YouTube, and here we can do npm run dev. And you see that it opens up over here, subscribers count. So I'm going to activate that. So now you can see we've got an item in our menu bar and it just says 5,000. We're only putting in the title. In this other command here, I already have my YouTube API key and my channel ID, as well as the kind of base API URL. So I'm going to just copy some of these things over here, because we're going to need the same ones. Because this is a private extension and it's only visible for us, then I'm going to leave the keys here. But obviously, if you were making this extension to publish to the public store, you would probably want to have that as a preference that the user pastes in. So that would work with any channel as well. So for now, we're going to take the use fetch from utils. And I don't really know what the data type is going to be yet. So I'm going to remove that. And I don't even know what URL I should be calling here. I'm not sure what the endpoint should be. So let me ask AI for that. What's the YouTube endpoint I need to call to fetch how many subscribers my channel has? In this example, it's using Axios. In our case, we can use the useFetch, which is directly from Raycast. And this API already handles, the whole fetching mechanism. And so let's see what we have here. We have this URL. So that would be YouTube/V3. So that's the same version as what we have, but will be /channels instead of /search. And then based on this count, we fetch this and then we get the count. Okay, so that should be pretty straightforward, actually. So now what I'm going to do, as always, start nice and simple. I'm just going to console log this. So let's see. Let's save that. Undefined. Undefined. Okay, I have an idea of what might be causing this. The useFetch hook returns a isLoading state so we can, load things properly. But also because the menu bar extra also has this prop, depending when the state of this isLoading change, which is happening internally, we need to know so we can update the value of the menu bar. So I'm going to try that. Oh, there you go. Now we actually get some data. This isLoading thing is important because it's a way that we optimize how often we refresh the menu bar item. Because it's living there forever, it's not something that we want to use too much memory. So it's important to make sure that we always use the isLoading whenever you're fetching data. I'm slightly frustrated that I just spend so much time on this, because every single time I built a menu bar extension, I tripped here. And I think I'm going to learn my lesson after this. Just to explain what happened, right? We are trying to log the data, and by default, the data is undefined. And because we don't use the isLoading from the useFetch hook, and we don't map that to the menu bar extra isLoading prop, that command is never updated. And the moment we do that, the moment that the useFetch goes from loading true to loading false, once we have the data, it then updates, and then we get the new updated data. So that's kind of what happened. So keep in mind, if you're building a menu bar extension that relies on any sort of like external data, always use the isLoading. All right, so let's resume. We do have the data. And if we look at the structure, what we're looking for here is items zero. So we can see we actually just have one item in the array. And then we go into the statistics object. And from there, we're just going to pick the subscribers count. Let's go ahead and do exactly that. So now we should be able to replace this with count. Let's see what happens. There we go. 3,220. That was nice. Aside from that little trip over there with isLoading, I felt like that was pretty straightforward. There's a couple of things we can do to make this better and nicer. First one, I think let's format this number a little bit, right? Add a little comma. We can add a little icon. And I even think we can go slightly further and add some menus. So when you click on it, we can maybe open the YouTube studio. How do we format a number nicely? To locale string? I don't remember. Can you format the subscribers count nicely for me? Please, let's be polite. So instead of 3220, make it 3220 like this, right? Absolutely. To locale string. Yeah, I was right.
Oh, it's giving you the whole thing.
It's going to give me the whole code. But once we get what we need, what we can do is just press enter to cancel. And now we can basically do all this. There we go. And now we can see that this is nicely formatted, much better. Before we go ahead and start adding more features to this, I want to talk a little bit about the background refresh, the interval in which this command will remount. So by default, when you render a menu bar extra in the menu bar, it's not going to update ever again. And if you want it to update, then we have to tell it to do so. This is because, again, for optimization, there are some menu bar extensions that don't actually need to be updated that often. But if you think about GitHub extension, this is a Raycast menu bar extension, Spotify and Linear. These are all menu bar extensions. We want this to update every 5 minutes, every 10 minutes. Spotify every like 30 seconds, more or less. I don't remember. I think it's 30 or 20 seconds. For this one, I don't think it needs to update that often, but let's maybe update it to every 15 minutes. So here in the package.json where we create our command, we can add an interval key. And here you can just specify how often we want this command to update. I don't remember if I can just put 15m or if it needs to be a value in seconds. So I'm just going to recap my memory here. And if I remember correctly, that's going to be in manifest interval. Oh, there you go. So we can do it like this. We can do 90 seconds, 1 minute, 12 hours. All right. So just to test that this is working, let's put 10 seconds. So now we can see under data undefined, where is the subscribers count? It's here, right? You see, every 10 seconds, we are getting the new log.
Yeah.
So 10 seconds works fine. But I wonder why the data is not coming through anymore. Oh, I know what it is. This is going to be slightly embarrassing, but I know what it is. The same thing is happening again. That if you're going to conditionally render a menu bar extra, then you got to also make sure that you set the isLoading, because this value changes, right? So if we render null, then the isLoading now is kind of non-existent. So we always have to make sure that isLoading is available even when you want to conditionally render something else. There you go. The value is back up here. Now we can see it's back in the menu bar. It's just the thing. Once you really remember that you gotta have the isLoading, because isLoading is what's going to tell Raycast to remount the extension, then it becomes like, you know, natural. But this has happened to me so many times in the past. So it's just one of those things. You forget about it, you trip over, it takes you 5 minutes to figure out, and then you're back to where you first began. Just to clarify, when we have no data, we just render an empty menu bar extra, and we make sure the isLoading is there. And when data changes, we're actually going to render this one over here, right, with the count. I think that we have an icon class over here that we should be able to do icon. Two people, save. There we go. So now we have our little icon up there. Two people, 3,220. Quite happy with this already, to be honest. We're now going to open up menu bar extra because we want to add some extra things in it. So this component has an item attached to it. So what we can do is render an item with a title, and this would be open in YouTube Studio. So now if we click here, you can see open in YouTube Studio, right? This is disabled because we haven't attached an action to this yet. That's the next step. But first, I just want to go to YouTube Studio up here, and yeah, let's get this URL, shall we? And we have an on action prop over here. This is the prop that gets called when you click on an item, right? It's like a callback. Let's go ahead and put a function here. And what we want to do is we want to basically open this in the browser. And to do that, we're going to use this API. It's called open. And we put in the URL. And now open in YouTube Studio, and it opens in the browser. There you go. That's nice. That's super simple.
Do you want to like build it and publish it to our store?
Yeah, let's do that. But first, I just want to do a couple of other things that I really like to do. I think it's good practice to do in these little extensions. One of them is the shortcuts. And the shortcut that we're going to want here is Command O. There you go. So now you see Command O over here. Now, another thing that I like to do for these extensions is, for these commands rather, is that if this extension has more than one command, I find that it's a really good idea to be able to launch other commands from the menu bar. So that's very easy to do. Let's go ahead and do it. Item. And the title is going to be show videos, right? For the lack of a better term. What we're going to do here is on action. We're going to put in the action that we need, right? I don't think we need any shortcuts for this. So now we have an API called launch command, and that's what we're going to use for this. How does that work? It works. Let me just refresh my memory over here. We give it a name and a type. All right. So the name would be the name of the command, which we can get from the package JSON. This is just search, right? This is deprecated. Oh, sorry, my bad. Let's put that in an object, shall we? And the type will be launch type. Let's import that dot user initiated. There you go. So now if we do show videos, it opens Raycast and it opens that specific command. And now we can see the videos directly in Raycast. Because this is a private extension, I'm not going to be publishing this to the public store. This is just for us here at Raycast. Obviously, if you're interested in this, I can provide a template that you can copy and paste. And if somebody wants to make this dynamic, then you're also welcome to build a proper extension that the user just puts in their channel ID or their API key, and it just works for anybody. So that's about how easy it is to create a simple extension that can solve a very unique problem. I think that that's one of the most powerful reasons to make an extension in Raycast. especially for teams that, you know, anybody in your organization can access. I hope this inspired you to make your own extensions. And if you do so, then let me know in the comments. I'll be reading them. And while you're here, make sure to check out this playlist with a few What's in My Raycast videos, where we talk to other people who use Raycast and learn about how they use it.